मोस्ट ऑफ द ACL सर्जन व्हेन द चाइल्ड गोज टू ACL सर्जन एंड इज टेल्स दैट दे हैव ACL इंजरी दे से दैट वी कैनॉट डू द सर्जरी राइट नाउ बिकॉज द एपिफाइशियल ग्रोथ टेड इज ओपन लेट्स वेट फॉर फ्यू ईयर्स व्हेन द चाइल्ड इज अबव 17 अबव 16 एंड व्हेन द फाइसिस इज क्लोज देन वी विल डू द सर्जरी। ACL tear treatment in children. Friends, if the ACL get damage in a child below 16 years of age, then the ACL surgery is very different from what we do in adults. Why? We are going to talk about this special topic today. So friends, if we see the anatomy of the bone in children, as you can see, this is the upper bone femur, this is the lower bone tibia. In children, when they are below 16 years, below 17 years in some children, then there is an epiphyseal growth plate on the femur and in the tibia. Bone growth always happens in this epiphyseal growth plate. So if any surgery in which some implant, if it crosses the epiphyseal growth plate, then it retards the growth of that particular limb in a children, resulting in limb length discrepancy, means that the operated limb will become a bit shorter than the non-operated limb. That's why most of the ACL surgeon, when the child goes to an ACL surgeon and is tells that they have an ACL injury, they say that we cannot do the surgery right now because the epiphyseal growth plate is open. Let's wait for a few years when the child is above 17, above 16, and then when the physis is closed, then we will do the surgery. But friends, because of the technical advancement, surgery in children with the open epiphyseal growth plate is very much possible. So what is the difference between a surgery in children? The name of the surgery which we do is all epiphyseal, all inside ACL reconstruction with fiber tape internal bracing, or physis sparring all inside ACL reconstruction with fiber tape internal brace. When we do a normal screw surgery in adults, as you can see, this is the screw. So the screw goes like this in the tibia. As you can see, friends, the screw will cross the physis and it will restrict the height of that particular limb if it is put inside a bone of a young child which is less than 16 years of age. That's why when we do all inside epiphyseal surgery, all epiphyseal surgery or growth sparring surgery, instead of the screw, we use very small automatic buttons. So these buttons are put below the epiphyseal plate of the femur and above the epiphyseal plate of the tibia. To make the special holes for these kind of surgery, we have a special zigs known as all inside zigs for femur and tibia, and we use a very special flip cutter to make the tunnels. As you can see, the flip cutter is very thin, so the hole in the cortex is very negligible, and once it goes inside the bone, we can flip it and make the bigger hole inside the bone, but the cortex will be a very small 4 mm hole. The special zig we use, and we make the tunnels for femur and tibia under image intensifier, which is the X-ray machine in the OR operation room, in which we can monitor whether the flip cutter is crossing the growth plate or not. So when we are using the flip cutter for the femoral tunnel, we make the hole like this, which is below the epiphyseal plate. And when we are using the flip cutter for the tibia, we make the hole like this, which is above the epiphyseal plate. So we don't cross the epiphyseal plate in neither in femur nor in tibia, resulting in ACL reconstruction, growth sparing ACL reconstruction, and it will not hamper the future growth of that particular limb in the child. So friends, if you think that your child has got an ACL tear and he is or she is below 16 years of age, you can send us their MRI. We want to see the X-rays of the child as well to confirm what is the status of the growth plate, and then we can suggest you what will be the best surgery for your child.